This is Mr. DiGiannino back to coming at you from a kitchen. This week we're going to do a three-part series called Naming Notes. And so the very first part of it's going to be quick, but the second part's a little bit longer. I do have a game to play with this at the end of the week. It's great practice, but we have to learn how to do this. And like the music in the beginning said, ABC 1, 2, 3, it really is that easy. And I don't want you thinking of it any other way. But this first video is just going to talk about why. Why do we have all these? And we're going to be talking about clefs today. And the reason why is because clefs tell us where on the keyboard we're going to be. If you can think back to that graphic I gave you with all the black lines, it's really, really confusing. And you really can't have 88 lines and different lines and spaces to tell where you're supposed to be. Music happens too quickly. And once it's gone, it's gone. You can't ever get it back. So we need a way that's a lot more safer. Now the clefs we're going to deal with is G clef. We call that the money clef. And the reason why is the money clef is one of those clefs that we use because that's where you make your money. That's where the people sing. Now some people sing higher and some people sing lower, which we use a different clef for. But that's the reason. Each clef puts you in a specific spot on the keyboard. And the G clef puts you right in the middle. All right, so we're going to learn a specific way of dealing with it because, you know, think about it like this, guys. A lot of you kids are always telling me, well, I know every girl and boy deserves fudge and face for the spaces. Yeah, that does work for one clef only while you're in it, okay? But what if you have these or these? What about those? You see, there's so many clefs, and I don't know about you, but I don't want to memorize, you know, 40 different lines and space phrases. It's just too long, especially when they all work exactly the same way. ABC, 1, 2, 3. Now we're going to deal with cycles. You can talk about cycles in science. Science means that when we have a cycle, it goes around in a circle, right? Well, we're going to use the numbers 1 through 7, okay? Take a look at my wheel. Now the wheel could go forward, it could go backwards, whatever we want it to do. Now, if we use the do, re, mi's, like in the song, we have do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. It's just Greek for numbers. Actually, a foreign language, I'm not exactly sure if it's Greek. But then, last but not least, we have the letters. 7 letters. A, B, C, D, E, F, G. All the same thing. All naming exactly the same thing, and boys and girls, certainly all of them relating to the same thing, which is your keyboard. We know what came first. The keyboard came first, and then your notes. Well, the keyboard to me is the same thing as a harp. Okay, so for those who are watching who aren't part of Saini. But nonetheless, all three are going to work the same way, and we're going to be able to name all the keys on the keyboard exactly using the same procedure. And that's what we're going to learn this week. And like I said, I have a game at the end. Now, number 2 video is going to be a little bit longer. You're going to have to bear with it a little bit. Please watch it all the way through. You will know what you're doing when you're done with it. Okay? So, ladies and gentlemen, here's what I would like you to do. Okay, your assignment. So what's your assignment? This is very simple. Boys and girls, do not do any more than what I'm going to do here because we're going to use this paper like last week. All right? So I drew my staff. Now, what I want to do is draw the G clef on top of it. And that's going to start it over the top line and underneath the bottom line. I'll make my P out of it like I showed you. I'm going to make my D out of it like I showed you. Bring that line underneath. And then we're going to wrap it around line number 2. Okay? This is your G clef. And clef means sign in Latin. Okay? So if it's a G sign, it tells you where the G is. So I want you to label G with the line going through it, just like this. That means any note that's on it is now called G. Line 2. Let me just number. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, always going up in the spaces. 1, 2, 3, and 4. There you go. Five lines, four spaces, always counting up. Boys and girls, let me see your staffs. A G clef and a G. Don't do any more than that, please, because the second part is going to be where you're going to use this. All right. Thank you. Thank you.